Hello students, in today's topic on Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and Rules 1945, we are going to study a very critical aspect of the pharmaceutical industry, that is the regulations which govern drugs and cosmetics. And the regulation is as per the guidelines laid down in the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and Rules 1945. So in this entire topic, we are going to learn all aspects of the rules and regulations that are meant to be complied with by manufacturers of pharmaceuticals as well as cosmetics. As you can see, the Act was initiated in the year 1940. Now, any Act describes the standards that are required, but how to achieve them and who will govern and who will inspect is determined by the rules, which came subsequently in the year 1945. Since then, number of supplements and addendum and changes in the rules have been incorporated from time to time, and any manufacturer of pharmaceuticals or cosmetics has to familiarize himself with not only the Act, Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and the rules, but also the latest amendments to the Act and rules. What we are going to do here is we are going to look at in general the Drugs and Cosmetics Act laid down in 1940 and Rules 1945. We are not going to look into the latest amendments. So moving forward, a brief recap of the history of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, which we have already seen previously. The Drugs and Cosmetics Act, let me call it as DNC Act henceforth, was passed in 1940 with the intention of regulating import, manufacture, distribution and sale of drugs and cosmetics. This act regulates the import of drugs into India so that no substandard or spurious drug will find its way into the country. This is a very, very important function governed by the act. The act regulates the manufacture by making provisions and rules that provide a control over the sale and distribution of drugs, which has to be done only by trained and qualified persons. This act, in addition to governing drugs and cosmetics, also provides for the control over manufacture, sale and distribution of Ayurvedic drugs, drugs belonging to Siddha, Unani and Homeopathy. Finally, the Drugs and Cosmetics Act regulates import, manufacture, sale and distribution of cosmetics. Thus, what is the scope of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act? It is drugs that are allopathic in origin, drugs which come from Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani, Homeopathy, and DNC Act also governs various aspects related to cosmetics. As per the DNC Act, import of certain drugs and cosmetics is permitted with appropriate license. However, all the classes of drugs and cosmetics that are imported into India shall comply with the standards that are laid down in the Act and shall be labeled accordingly in the prescribed manner. Similarly, manufacture of all classes of drugs requires prior license issued by the licensing authority. License is also required for the sale of allopathic and homeopathic drugs. Thus, we see that DNC Act covers not only localized manufacture, but it also covers import of drugs each state, as per the act, each state is supposed to appoint a licensing authority which will issue or grant license for the manufacture or sale of cosmetics. Because drugs can save lives or they can take lives, strict control over manufacture and sale of drugs is necessary and is exercised by people who are called as drug inspectors. Testing of the quality of the drugs before it goes into the market is very essential, and this function is performed by drug control laboratories or at the state level or the central level. Thus, we have drug control laboratories of state or central drug laboratory performing the analysis of drugs and cosmetics. We will learn about this in much more detail as we go ahead. What I am telling you right now is just a brief overview of the DNC Act and rules. The Act provides for establishment of Drug Technical Advisory Board, DTAB, which is responsible for advising the government on technical matters arising out of administration of the Act, as well as the establishment of the Drugs Consultative Committee, which will advise the board and the government to secure uniformity in administration of the Act throughout India. Remember, India is a very big country and it has many geographical variations, because of which the implementation of a single DNC Act and its rules will be highly impossible unless there are some bodies which are governing and regulating its implementation. And these bodies are the Drug Technical Advisory Board and the Drugs Consultative Committee. We will learn about these two committees, these two bodies as we move ahead. So coming to the actual DNC Act, the DNC Act consists of 5 chapters. Each chapter deals with a particular topic. So these are the 5 chapters. Chapter 1, which deals with the definitions, various definitions, which we will see in our next slide. Chapter 2 deals with these bodies, the Drug Technical Advisory Board, Drugs Consultative Committee, and the Central Drug Laboratory, which are responsible for testing of the drugs and cosmetics. Chapter 3 deals with rules and regulations for import of drugs and cosmetics. Chapter 4 deals with the procedure for manufacture, sale, and distribution of drugs and cosmetics. Chapter 4A gives the provisions related to Ayurvedic, Unani, Siddha and homeopathic drugs, and certain other aspects are covered under Chapter 5. We begin with Chapter 1, where several important definitions have been given. I have jotted down these definitions in my slides and I am going to explain to you as I read along. So the very first definition, most important definition, is that of a drug. There are 4 subpoints under the definition for drugs, and you are expected to know and write the entire definition. So let me read out what are drugs as per DNC Act. First point. All medicines for internal or external use of human beings or animals, and all substances intended to be used for or in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation, which means reduction, or prevention of any disease or disorder in human beings or animals, including preparations applied on the human body for the purpose of repelling insects such as mosquitoes. So this is one small part of the definition, and I will go through it again for better understanding. So drugs includes all medicines for internal or external use, so whether it is a tablet or whether it is a cream, of human beings or animals. So the veterinary preparations are also covered under DNC Act. And all substances intended to be used for or in, so whatever is necessary for diagnosis, so diagnostic kit is also a drug, treatment, a tablet is a drug, mitigation, that is reduction, certain therapies which are meant to reduce pain, they come under drugs, or prevention of any disease, so vaccines are drugs, or disorder in human beings or animals, including preparations applied on the body for the purpose of repelling insects like mosquitoes. So insect repellent, mosquito repellents are also classified as drugs. The second part of the definition says such substances other than food intended to affect the structure or function of the human body or intended to be used for the destruction of vermin or insects which cause disease in human beings or animals. The definition further says, all substances intended for use as components of drug, including empty gelatin capsules. All of you have heard about the dosage form capsules, hard gelatin capsules, where you have a powder that is filled within the capsule shell. While the powder itself contains the API, the empty gelatin shell is also considered to be a drug and is falls under the purview of the DNC Act. Then devices intended for internal or external use in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation or prevention of disease or disorders in human beings or animals. So devices are also falling under the category of drugs. So syringes, needles, insulin pumps, inhalers, empty inhaler cans of asthma inhalers, all of these are devices which fall under the category of drug and are therefore coming under the purview of DNC Act. So thus we have seen the definition of drug includes four subparts. We have been through these subparts and also tried to understand the definition of the drug in its entirety. So drug is not only something that we pop into the body, that we pop into the mouth. It consists of medications for internal use, medications for external use, medications, substances which are a part of your formulation such as empty gelatin capsules, devices that help in diagnosis, detection, prevention of disease, etc. Right? So this is the entire definition of drugs. Let us see what is the next definition given. If drugs are not of a standard quality, then they are labeled as substandard drugs. There are several words which are used for the substandard drugs. One of the names assigned is called as misbranded drug. Let us try to understand what is a misbranded drug. If it is so colored, coated, powdered or polished that damage is concealed, or if it is made to appear of a better or greater therapeutic value than what it is really, if it is not labeled in the prescribed manner, if its label or container or anything accompanying the drug bears a statement, design or device which makes a false claim for the drug or which is false or misleading in any particular way. So the definition of misbranded refers to those drugs, those formulations which have been deliberately altered so as to conceal some damage, or it is made to appear to be very effective, or if some of the instructions are missing on the label, or the label consists of any, a label or container contains any statement which is making a false claim for the drug. So suppose you have a container containing tablets and there is a label on it saying that these tablets can cure cancer. It is a misbranded drug because the claim made on the label is false. Sometimes it may so happen that the tablet, which is supposed to be white in color, shows some slight coloration because of impurity. If the manufacturer deliberately coats this tablet to cover its surface and to hide the coloration, discoloration, then such a drug is called as a misbranded drug. Okay. So I hope the concept of misbranded drug is clear to you. Deliberate attempt to hide some fault or provide some false information and thereby making it appear as if the drug is having high therapeutic value. All such drugs, if they are discovered by the regulatory agencies, they will label it as misbranded drugs. Let us now try to understand the meaning of the word adulterated drug. The DNC Act defines the adulterated drug as one which consists in whole or in part of any filthy, putrid or decomposed substance that is totally spoiled. A drug is considered to be adulterated if it has been prepared, packed or stored under insanitary conditions because of which it may have been contaminated with filth or whereby it may have been rendered injurious to health. If its container is composed in whole or in part of any poisonous or deleterious substance which may render the contents injurious to health. A drug is considered to be adulterated if it bears or contains a color other than the prescribed colors. Drug is considered to be adulterated if it contains harmful or toxic substances and if any substance is mixed with it so as to reduce its quality or strength. Thus, on this slide, we have read the definition of adulterated drug, whereby if the drug is filthy, putrid or decomposed, it has been prepared, packed or stored under insanitary conditions, or if its container is consisting of a poisonous or deleterious substance, or if it contains an unapproved color, or if it contains harmful or toxic substances, or if it is mixed with any substance that reduces its quality or strength, then such a drug is said to be an adulterated drug. Next comes spurious drugs. What are spurious drugs? A drug is said to be spurious if it is imported under a fake name, that is a name that belongs to another drug. If it is an imitation or a substitute for another drug, or it resembles another drug in a manner likely to deceive, or bears upon it or upon its label or container the name of another drug, unless plainly or conspicuously marked so as to reveal its true nature and its lack of identity with such drugs. A drug is said to be spurious if its label bears the name of an individual or company purporting to be its manufacturer, but the individual or the company is fake or fictitious. A drug which has been substituted wholly or partly by another drug or substance, and the drug which purports to be the product of a manufacturer of whom it is not truly a product. So, a spurious drug is one which is either imported under a fake name or it is an imitation. It imitates another drug or resembles another drug, or its label or container gives the name of the company or manufacturer, but it is fake. A drug which inside has been substituted wholly or partly by a drug or by a placebo, or and a drug which is supposed to be the product of a manufacturer, but it is actually not manufactured by that company, then such a drug is called as a spurious drug. What is a new drug? Now, you must have heard of the term new drug. Whenever a company carries out research, a pharmaceutical company carries out research, and it comes out with a new molecule or a new product to be launched in the market, then this product or this drug is called as a new drug. So let us see what is the definition of a new drug. A new substance of chemical, biological or biotechnological origin, either in the bulk, that is pure API form, or prepared dosage form, used for the prevention, diagnosis or treatment of disease in man or animals, which, except during the local clinical trials, has not been used in the country to any significant extent. Thus, the first part of the definition of the new drug refers to an API or a formulation that is required for the prevention, diagnosis or treatment of disease in man and animals, but has so far not been used except for clinical trials. The second half of the definition says that a drug already approved by the licensing authority for certain claims, but is now proposed to be marketed with modified or new claims for indications or new dosage form or new route of administration. So any drug which will be used for diagnosis, treatment or prevention of disease but has not been used so far is a new drug. Any drug which was previously used for a particular disease but will now be repurposed and used for treatment of another condition are both fall under the category of new drug. Third part of a new drug. A fixed dose combination of two or more drugs individually approved earlier for certain claims which are now proposed to be combined for the first time in a ratio, or already marketed ratio will be changed with certain claims such as change in indications or change in dose or change in dosage form or change in the route of administration. So two or more drugs that were earlier administered individually to patients for a certain therapy, if they are combined for the first time in a single dosage form, they are classified as a new drug. Similarly, if the already existing two drugs in a particular formulation, if their dosage is changed, either reduced or increased, this also forms a new drug. So a new drug under the above definition shall continue to be considered as a new drug for a period of 4 years from the date of its first approval or its inclusion in the Indian pharmacopoeia, whichever is earlier. So a drug or a formulation will be classified as a new drug for 4 years after its first permission or till it is included in the Indian pharmacopoeia. Whereas this is for drugs that are given by the oral route. All vaccines shall be considered as new drugs unless certified otherwise by the licensing authority. So vaccine will be a new drug for an indefinite period of time till it is considered to be no longer a new drug. What does the word manufacture mean? The DNC Act says that in relation to any drug or cosmetic, manufacture includes any process or part of the process for making, altering, ornamenting, finishing, packing, labeling, breaking up, or otherwise treating or adopting any drug or cosmetic for sale or distribution, but does not include the compounding or dispensing of any drug or the packing of any drug in the ordinary course of retail business. Here, think of any activity in relation to a formulation. Let us say you consider a tablet. Okay, so making of the tablet is a part of manufacture. Coating of the tablet, which comes under altering or ornamenting, is a manufacture. Finishing, polishing of the tablets, packing of the tablets, labeling or breaking up or otherwise any other treatment of the drug or the cosmetic becomes a part of manufacture. So any activity that is responsible for the production, packing, altering the appearance is a part of manufacturing of the drugs. And on this slide is written the definition of the word manufacture as per the DNC Act. Once again, I will read it to you. In relation to any drug or cosmetic, it includes any part or a part of a process or part of a process for making, altering, ornamenting, finishing, packing, labeling, breaking up or otherwise treating or adopting any drug or cosmetic for sale or distribution, but does not include, what does it not include? The compounding or dispensing of a drug that is done at a dispensary level, where the doctor or the pharmacist gives various medications by breaking the strip and giving a small amount, or the packing at the counter, which is done in the retail business, that does not become a part of the definition of manufacture. So these were some of the important definitions in connection with drugs. Let us now move on to cosmetic. What is a cosmetic? The DNC Act says that any article intended to be rubbed, poured, sprinkled, or sprayed on, or introduced into, or otherwise applied to the human body or any part thereof for the cleansing, beautifying, promoting attractiveness, or altering the appearance, and includes any article intended for use as a component of the cosmetic. So any article that is applied onto the body for altering the appearance or cleansing or beautifying is defined as a cosmetic as per the definition. So go through this definition once again to understand it better and apply it in your mind to the various cosmetics that are available in the marketplace. So if a cosmetic is not of the given standards, then what are the words that are used in connection with such cosmetics? One of the words used is a misbranded cosmetic, which is nothing but a cosmetic that contains a color which is not prescribed, or a cosmetic that is not labeled in the prescribed manner, or the label or container or anything accompanying the cosmetic bears a statement which is false or misleading in any particular. Okay, so a cosmetic which is not having an approved color, it is not labeled in the prescribed manner or contains a false declaration, a false statement, is called as a misbranded cosmetic. A spurious cosmetic is one which is imported under a name that belongs to another cosmetic. It is an imitation of another cosmetic or resembles another cosmetic in a manner likely to deceive, or bears upon it or its label or container the name of another cosmetic. DNC Act says that if the label or container or anything that accompanies the cosmetic bears a statement which is false or fictitious, then such a cosmetic is a spurious cosmetic. Also, if the cosmetic claims to be a product of a manufacturer of whom it is not, then again such a cosmetic is classified as a spurious cosmetic. So, in the previous slide, we looked at the various conditions under which the cosmetic is labeled as misbranded. In the current slide, we looked at the various conditions due to which a cosmetic may be branded as spurious. And a spurious cosmetic is one which may be imported under a name belonging to another cosmetic. It is an imitation of another cosmetic, or it contains the name of another cosmetic on its label, or the label contains a statement which is false or fictitious, or it claims to be the product of a manufacturer who has not manufactured it. So these are the conditions under which the cosmetic is classified as a spurious cosmetic. The next definition given in Chapter 1 of DNC Act is that of Ayurveda, Siddha or Yunani drug. It says that all medicines intended for internal or external use, for or in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation or prevention of disease or disorder in human beings or animals, and manufactured in accordance with the formulae described in the authoritative books of Ayurveda, Siddha or Yunani systems specified in the first schedule. So, the first schedule to the DNC Act gives a list of books which are authoritative books in Ayurveda, in Siddha and in the Yunani system of medicine. So, if the formulation has been prepared by the formulae that are stated in these books, then the drug, then the formulation is considered to be an Ayurvedic or Siddha or Yunani formulation, and the drug is supposed to be used for internal or external use, for in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation or prevention of disease and disorder. The next definition that we look at is a patent or proprietary medicine. A very important definition, because you must have heard the word patent numerous times. So, what is a patent and proprietary medicine? A drug which is a remedy or a prescription presented in a form ready for internal or external administration in human beings or animals, and which is not included in the edition of the pharmacopoeia for the time being, or any other pharmacopoeia authorized in this behalf by the central government after consultation with the Drugs Technical Advisory Board. So, in brief, a patent medicine or a proprietary medicine is an unofficial medicine that is not included in Indian pharmacopoeia, nor included in other pharmacopoeias that are approved by the government, and it is used for internal or external administration in human beings or animals.